Hello folks, my name is George Amadova. I am a realtor, real estate investor, and author of The No BS in Making Millions in Real Estate. Today's topic is how to buy houses with no cash using lease option. Now the reason why I'm giving you this information is because I remember when I started out, I come from humble beginnings. I remember how hard it was for my dad when he was working off the books for minimum wage. My mother was a welfare recipient, and it was very hard for us growing up. I remember working since I was 11 years old, and honestly, I hated it because I wanted to have fun like every other child was having fun, and I was here working just to make ends meet, to be able to buy my clothes for school, you know, to look nice so people won't criticize me and make fun of me in school. So I know how it is, and I remember working for someone else, and working for someone else is not something I highly recommend. I mean, if you're happy with your job, then hey, so be it. If you have a career, great, but there are many Americans working for minimum wage or working for $10, $12 an hour, and they can't take off when they want to. They can't take vacation when they want to. They don't spend enough time with their family because they're constantly working. And then at the end of the week, once they get paid, it all goes on bills. They can't even make the rent. So, I mean, I know how that is. I remember those days, which is why I got involved in real estate. And this is why I give you that information. Granted, real estate is not for everyone. However, if you have an entrepreneurial spirit, this may work for you. And sometimes, again, you may not have the money. So this is why I give you these options, which really help you to get involved in real estate. Now, the first thing you want to do is using a lease option. Okay, you want to look for any landlord who's interested in selling, okay, or renting to with an option to sell. So the way you do it is you get a lease for a year, and I'm using numbers as an example. Let's say $4,000 rent for a year, with a separate contract that is a lease option. Okay, and that lease option has an option price, which for example will be $3,000. It could be five, it could be 10, but I'm giving you an example, $3,000, and basically stipulates on that contract that if you are able to exercise the option or buy the property within a year, okay, that amount of money will be used as down payment or credit towards the purchase of the property, as well as you could put a certain amount of the rents every month that you pay, and you could, for example, stipulate that 15% of the rent, let's say for example, $1,000 a month, 15% will be $150, will be allocated as credit towards a down payment on the purchase on the property. Now, I will not sign the contract agreement and I will not sign the option until I put an ad in the newspaper or on Craigslist looking for someone who's interested in renting to own or renting with an option to buy. Okay, now when I decide to rent to someone else, obviously I will ask for a higher rent agreement compared to what I'm paying. So in other words, if I'm paying $1,000, I want $1,250 or $1,500. So that gives me a little leeway. Okay, same thing as the option. If the option that I have with the landlord is $3,000, I want the option with the subtenant for $5,000. Keep in mind that has to be stipulated on the contract, and you have to have the agreement with the landlord that you will be subleasing. Okay, so you want these different prices because number one, you want cash flow, you want to make money. Secondly, you got to protect yourself just in case if the tenant doesn't pay, which remember, you have to do your due diligence. Okay, you have to verify the tenant, make sure he qualifies. You want to look for a credit score at least a minimum of 580 and above. And the reason why I say that is because that prospect tenant, you want him or her to be able to qualify for an FHA loan, so he's able to exercise the option and buy the house. So you want to take into consideration the credit score and the income. You want to look on the ratio at least a minimum of 31% to gross income. So in other words, 31% of the gross income has to be able to pay the mortgage, the principal, the interest, the taxes, and insurance on that property. So you have to learn a little bit of math. This book will explain a little more. However, that's the way you want to protect yourself. Now, once you have the prospect, then you will sign the option agreement, you will sign the lease, and then you will sublease to this tenant with a higher rental agreement and a higher option price. Now, in your option, you may have a two-year option. With the tenant, you may want to make it a year, and you want to make it for 18 months the most, but be able to extend it for every year. And the reason why I state that is because you want to give yourself a leeway to exercise the option. If you do decide to exercise the option because the subtenant wants to exercise it, what I do is either I will do a double closing, okay, Or honestly, I would do what is called an assignment. I will sign the contract over to the tenant or subtenant, and I will be able to get the difference and make that profit. Okay. Same thing with the sale price. If the sale price, for instance, that you're buying it for is $150,000, as an example, okay, you wanna be able to sell it maybe for $175,000. Now, I did this myself. I know it works. For instance, they had to, on one of the properties that I did the lease option, I did have to paint it and update it a little, but nevertheless, it worked and I made a profit. So this is something you may want to consider because, again, this is no money out of your own pocket. But you want to secure yourself. You want to be safe because you want to make that money. You don't want to get caught with a tenant not paying rent and then you still gotta honor your agreement. So keep that in mind. If you want more information, just please write below, comment, or ask me the question, or shoot me out an email, and I'll be more than happy to assist you. For more information, read my book, The No BS in Making Millions in Real Estate. It will actually help you out. Thank you very much. Have a blessed day. And watch my other videos, by the way. Thank you. Bye-bye.